Hello, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to us all to this session in which we are going to do Arabic grammar. We are going to see a new topic, and I hope we are in good shape of health and mind such that we can follow the lesson keenly and religiously. And I pray the previous lessons are well understood. As I've been saying, Nahu is like making a story building. The foundation needs to be strong so that it can carry the whole body, the other stories. It can carry the whole floors. If the foundation is weak, the pillars are weak, and you decide to build on it, you are just killing yourself. You are setting a destructive trap for yourself. And so, in Nahu, when the foundation is not strong and you build upon it, you keep learning, you get to a point you've learned a whole lot, but your understanding becomes very corrupted. That's why I keep repeating, try as much as possible to understand whatever is done in each episode very well. If there is anything that is unclear, try to ask. Do your possible best to understand that before you move to the next lesson. Because the author of the book has done it in such a style that we call tadarruj, stage by stage. You keep climbing. So we need to climb with him so that he will take us to where he intends to take us. And I trust the process here. Okay, so I'm going to go into the lesson from here. Our topic is kana wa akhawatuha. Akhawat is the plural of ukht, sister, ukht. And then it says kana wa akhawatuha, kana and its sisters. Kana is a verb, so we say the verb kana and its sisters. Its sisters is literal. What it means is that kana has a kind of contribution it brings to the sentence it is found in. So when you have a sentence and kana is in the sentence, it has its own effect, which I would like to term the kana effect. Okay. Because it has a contribution it brings and it changes certain things, we give it a special attention. There are verbs that act just like kana. They also cause the same changes. They bring the same contribution to the sentence. And so we gather them together and we say they are sisters of kana. So they are together, they are treated together. Okay, let's get right into the amsila and see it clearly what he really means. That the topic really means. Okay, now we have a lot of words here because the examples are a whole lot. So you need to really concentrate. Okay, so here, amsila, the number one, it says, Az-zihamu shadidun. Az-zihamu shadidun. Az-ziham is the traffic. Az-ziham, traffic or crowd. Some say is the ham. They all have the same, almost the same meaning. So az-ziham here, the traffic, or is the ham. Some would like to say al-izdihamu shadidun. Some will say az-zihamu shadidun. There will definitely be a slight difference, but not now. Now we know that az-ziham means traffic or crowd. Okay. Az-zihamu shadidun. The traffic is severe, or the crowd is severe. Okay. What is done here is that the sentence is brought and kana is added to the sentence so that you see clearly what has happened to the sentence. So what I'm going to do is I'll read the one here and I'll read its counterpart where kana is added so that we will move in a very logical step. So at every stage, you see the change that occurred. Okay. Az-ziham shadidun, the crowd or the traffic is severe. Now kana is added here. You can see it here. It says kana az-ziham shadidan. Please let's note these changes here. Here we have shadidun and here we have shadidan. You go with me in this sense. Now, this sentence we have here is a subject and predicate. It's mubtada and khabar. You can easily go back to the al-jumla, al-ismiya, or go back to mubtada and khabar. You see sentences just like this. One comes like that with doma, the other comes with doma. The first one has alif and lam, the second does not have. Mubtada and khabar as we treated there. If you forgot it, you just refresh there and get back here. Here is al-jumla al-ismiya, where we have mubtada and then we have our khabar. Now let's look what changes here. We have kana azzihamu shadidan. So from shadidun to shadidan. What caused this shadidan is the introduction of kana. When kana comes and joins a jumla ismiya, the khabar changes from marfu, that is changes from taking dhamma to taking fatha. So instead of dhamma, you see fatha. So the khabar kana changes the khabar to mansub. Instead of marfu, which is dhamma, it changes it to mansub, which is fatha. Okay, next sentence. Al baytu nazifun. The house is clean. That is mubtada and khabar. Now kana is added here. Just kana al baytu, the mubtada stays as it is. Nazifan. So you note here again that fatha has been introduced. The khabar has become mansub instead of the original marfu it was. Okay, let's go on. We have again al-thawbu qasirun. Now this is kana. Kana is done. We are going to start seeing the sisters of kana. Okay. The first one of those is we have al-thawbu qasirun. Al-thawbu is dress. A dress. So the dress is short. Qasir means short. The opposite of tawil. You have tawil and qasir. So qasir is short. The dress is short. And then we have swara introduced here. So swara is ukhtu kana. It's a sister to kana. Okay, so we have swara al-thawbu qasiran. Look at it here, the same function. That's why we say it is kana's sister. The dress has become short. I don't know if I forgot to give the meaning of kana. Kana means was. So when kana is introduced to a jumla ismiya, it takes the meaning to the past. So the traffic is severe. Here we will have the traffic was severe. And then here the house is neat or clean. We will have the house was clean. So it has changed something slightly. So kana means was. Okay, now let's come back to swara. Swara means to become, to change into. All these will be explained in the bath, but I want to give you my own explanation. Said that if it differs, whichever you find very cool, then it works with you. Okay, so we have swara al-thawbu qasiran. The dress has become short. Here you can see the fatha thing. Al-bardu qarisun. Qarisun means severely cold. I think we met this word in Al-Qira'at al-Rashida lessons. Qarisun, severely cold. So al-bardu, the cold is severe. Qarisun. So you see that shadid means severe, but it isn't used for al-bardu. It can be said al-bardu shadidun. But the most fitting word is qarisun. So if you are in cold, like snowy place, it's getting really cold. Say al-bardu qarisun. The cold is severe. Okay. So we have swara again. Swara al-bardu qarisan. So you can see that fatatain has come instead of the domatain. So with this, you can just do your own example. And what I will advice, or what I will say, is that you look at the Quran and you see examples of this. Wa kana Allahu ghafuran. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا. You look in the Quran, you see a lot of these kind of sentences coming like that. So you familiarize yourself with it. And reading a lot too, you meet a lot of these. Okay, let's calm down. Sawara means to become, which is sayrura, to change into. So sawara al-bardu qarisan means that the cold was not severe before, but it has become, it has changed into. That is what we call sayrura, changing into. I will tell you, sawara al-mindilu malan. Sawara al-mindilu malan. The handkerchief has become money, changing in form. Okay, that is sayrura. Now let's get to the next one. We have al-khadimu qawiyun. Al-khadimu is servant, qawiyun, strong. Al-khadimu qawiyun, the servant is strong. Then we have here, so here laysa is ukht kana. Laysa means is not. Laysa is not. We have laysa al-khadimu qawiyan. Here you can see your fathatain coming clearly. So just from here you can just observe they all come like that. We have here al-amilu. Al-amilu means the worker. Nashitun is active. Nashit, active. The worker is active. So we have laysa al-amilu nashitun. So when you have a sentence and you just want to bring in any of these meanings, you want to say, you know the boy, they say, somebody says al-waladu tawilun. Al-waladu tawilun. A correct jumla ismiya. And you want to say, no, he is not tall. The boy is not tall. You want to say he's not tall. You just bring in your laysa. You bring the same sentence, but you make the khabar fatatain. So you say, laysa al-waladu tawilan. That is just what the grammar we need to understand from this session. Okay. The next sister, we have an-nahimu maridun. As I said, you will see a lot of words. The word an-nahimu means a glutton, depending on the country you are listening to this from. Me being a Ghanaian, or let me say my own accent, I would say glutton. Once I was speaking with some students, or I was teaching some students, I said glutton and they were like, glitten. Like, what's that? So G-L-U-T-T-O-N. I think that's the word. So some would like to say an eater, somebody who eats a lot. Some would like to pronounce it glutton, some would like to say glutton. Our attention is the grammar we need to capture from here. Okay, so we have an-nahimu maridun. The glutton or the eater is sick. So we have the next sister we have here is asbaha. Now, even if you are handling the book or if you are watching the video directly, I will advise you write down the sisters of Kena. Kena and his sisters, write them down, memorize them, and write their meanings attached to them as we explain, so that you memorize them. Okay. So we have an-nahimu maridun, the eater or the glutton is sick. And then we have here asbaha an-nahimu maridun. This is the effect we are looking for. Asbaha means to become, but it is not, doesn't have the meaning of sayrura, changing into. We use it to mean that, but that is not a specific function. Now we will come to see the differentiation factor between the asbaha and the rest. All these things, we come and see that difference very clearly. Okay. So asbaha means generally to become. Asbaha an-nahimu maridan. The glutton or the eater, excessive eater, has become sick or has fallen sick. Then we have al-jawu mumtirun. The weather is rainy, or the atmosphere is rainy. That is, there is rain in there. And then we have here asbaha al-jawu. The mubtada is still dhamma. Mumpiran. You see your fatha there? So from marfu here to mansub here. So when Asbaha or any of the sisters of Kena comes, the khabar becomes mansub. It moves from is marfu to mansub. Okay, let's go on. So Asbaha means to become. Then we have Al-Amilu Mut'abun. Al-Amilu, we've seen it, the worker. Mut'abun means tired. Mut'abun means tired. A lot of people, or let me say some students make the mistake here, some mistake here, and they say Mut'abun. Like the person will say, Ana Mut'abun. Now, when you give the Ayn Kesra here, it tends to the thing that causes stress, that causes tiredness. So if you say Ana Mut'abun, that is, I'm stressed or I'm tired. Something has caused me to be tired. But when you say something is Mut'abun, Abun instead of Abun, Mut'abun, that is the thing that causes the stress. So if I say Al-Amalu, Al-Amalu, not Amilu, Al-Amalu, the work, Mut'abun, is stressful. The work is stressful. And so what? Al-amilu mut'abun. The worker is stressed or is tired. I hope that is clear. So if you say I'm tired, you can say ana mut'abun. Some will say ta'ban. It's not bad. Ana ta'ban. Say ana mut'abun. I am tired. So we have the sister of Kena here, Amsa. So Amsa al-amilu mut'abun. Mut'abun. Can see the fatha ten here. The worker has become stressed or tired. As I said, I will explain the difference between this become. Okay. Az-zahru, the flower, dhabilun, is withering or has withered. Az-zahru, dhabil, the flower is has dried up or has withered. Okay. Amsa az-zahru dhabilan. The flower has become withered or dried up. Okay. Done with Amsa 2. Keep marking them. Amsa 2 is gone. We have al-ghamam kathifun. Al-ghamam is clouds. Clouds. Kathif means thick. Kasif means thick or dense. So the clouds are dense or are thick. Okay. Then we have Adha al-Ghamam Kathifan. You can see the fathatain there, and this is causing it. Adha is part of the sisters of Kena. It says Adha al-Ghamam Kathifan. The clouds have become thick. Okay. Ash-shari'u muzdahimun. The road or the street is trafficked. Muzdahimun. If you remember, I told you az-ziham, you can say al-izdiham. So ash-shari'u muzdahimun. The road is crowded or trafficked. Okay, so we have Adha Ash-Shari'u Muzdahimun. Muzdahiman, afwan. Adha Ash-Shari'u Muzdahiman. The street has become crowded. Okay. Al-Mataru Gazirun. Gazir means heavy. A lot. If gazir is used to describe water, it means a lot, voluminous. Al-matar, the rain, is heavy, gazir. Okay, now we have the sister of Kena here, which is Zolla. Zolla means to remain, to remain. So we have Zolla, al-matar, the doma is still there, gaziran. Realize that this part has changed. The rain remained heavy. ظل المطر جزيرا. The rain remained heavy. Or it kept raining heavily. Okay. الغبار ثائر. You've seen this sentence about thrice. The dust is rising. الغبار ثائر. The dust is rising. Now we have here ظل الغبار ثائرا. Instead of سائر, now we have ثائرا. إيران. فتعتين. So ظل means to remain. So you say the dust kept rising. Okay. And then we have our last one. المصباح متقد. مصباح is lamp. And متقد is lighted up. The lamp is lighted up. Or the lamp is burning. You know those lamps that are real fire. You say the lamp is burning. Or the lamp is lighted up. متقد. Okay. Then we have bata. This is the sister of Kenna here, bata. So we have bata المصباح متقدا. The lamp remained, or the lamp, let's say the lamp remained lighted up. Okay. Then we have here المريض متألم. The patient is in pain. Muta'allimun. Now note here, this is Hamza. Hamza and Lam. If you say muta'allimun, ah, bil'ayn, if you use ayn, muta'allim, it means a student, somebody who is learning. But the sound is ah, muta'allimun, muta'allimun. The patient is in pain from alama, from alam, alamun, pain. Okay. So we go to bata al-maridu muta'alliman. The patient kept feeling the pains. Now, before we go into the explanation, let me explain some key points here to you before we get into the explanation. From swara, we learned swara is to transform into or change into, move from one condition to the other. Swara. Which I said is swayrura, to change into. Okay. Laysa, I said the meaning is not or are not. Asbaha. Now this is where I really want us to notice. Asbaha, you can see the item of sabah, morning, in here. So asbaha means to wake up or to come into your morning. So asbaha nahimu maridan. If the Arab hears this, asbaha means to become, but he knows this to become is to become in the morning. So if I say asbaha nahimu maridan, it can be understood that in the night he was not sick. Let's get this part clear. Asbaha nahimu maridan can mean, or actually means, that in the night he was not sick, but he got up sick. Instead of sabah al khair, somebody greeting you, sabah al khair, good morning, somebody can say kaifa asbahta, kaifa asbahta, how did you wake up? If you can say asbahtu maridan, I woke up sick, or asbahtu qawiyan, asbahtu jayidan, I woke up very fit or good. This is the same thing here. Asbaha an-nahimu, the glutton or the eater, got up, woke up sick. Asbaha means to become, but it has the item of as-sabah. Let's note that. Okay. Amsa also means to become. But amsa has the item of masa, which is afternoon or evening to night. Evening to night, or let's say sometimes from afternoon to night, all is masa. Amsa al-amilu mut'aban. That means the worker got into his evening tired. He has worked from morning, so let's say by 3 p.m. he became tired. So you say amsa al-amilu mut'aban. He got tired. When you say this, you don't need to say amsa al-amilu mut'aban fi as-sa'a al-thalisa masaan. You don't need to say you got tired at 3 p.m. and all that. No, 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 you don't need that. The moment you say amsa al-amilu mut'aban, the one who understands Arabic knows that, oh, amsa, that means he got tired in the evening. You are talking about he becoming tired in the evening. I hope this point is also clear. Now, adha. Adha also has to do with adduha. Adduha is also time. We even have a prayer, the Muslims pray Salatul Duha. Just like about the sun rising. Some call it forenoon or so. Just about the time when the sun will come out. I think it differs from the country you are in. After the dawn, just before the sun, the first phase of the sun, Muslims say a particular prayer there, Nafila. That is, they pray an optional prayer, which is 2 units of prayer. They say it at that time, before the sun shows face. That is the time we call Abduha. So you can check up in Surah Al-Duha in the Quran, the chapter Abduha. It says, Wadduha wal-layl iza saja. You can check it there and you get more insight into that. So it says, Abduha al-ghamam kathifan. So here we understand that the clouds became thick, but when? At that particular time. At that time of around here in Ghana, I think around almost 6 o'clock a.m. Almost 6 o'clock a.m. or let's say 6:30, at most 6:30, 6:45, thereabout, up to 7. Abduha, we are in that time. So when somebody says Abduha al-Ghamam kathifan, you understand that it is in this particular time of the morning that the person is talking about. Okay. Zalla has to do with the day, to remain throughout the day. So that is not really complicated. But bata means, bata even has the meaning of nama. Bata has the meaning of nama. We might have to sleep. Okay. Bata also means to go through your night, not necessarily sleep. Okay, so bata, you can say bata abitu. You can say abitu layli fi qira'atil Quran. I spend my night. Bata means to go through the night, not necessarily sleep. Whether you slept, whether you don't sleep, is bata, to go through the night. So you can say abitu layli fi qira'atil Quran, abitu layli na'iman. I spend my night sleeping. I spend my night in reading the Quran. I spend my night in doing what? Abitu. So you can, there is this saying that some link to Imam Shafi, some link to Imam Suyuti. They say, abitu saharana duja, watabituhu nauman, watabghi ba'da dhalika lahaqi. I spend my night, abitu saharana duja. I spend my night, I spend the darkness awake. Watabituhu. Bata, this same bata is being conjugated. Tabituhu, and you spend your night. No, watabituhu nauman, you spend it sleeping. Watabghi ba'da dhalika, and you seek after that. Lahaki, to catch up with me. Because I spend my night awake, doing a lot of work, and you are asleep throughout. You seek to catch up with me. It's a nice quote like that. Abitu saharan al-duja, watabituhu nauman. Okay. So that is bata. So he says bata al-misbahu mutaqidan. What we understand from here is that the lamps remained lighted up throughout the night. Again here, bata al-maridu muta'alliman. The patient went through his night in pain. These are the meanings and the differences. Just write every detail down and try to look at them clearly, very well. Now let's get to the bus. Almost 90% of the work has been done. So it's going to be a freestyle reading. Al-Bas, explanation. He says, Kullu mithalin. As I said, after kullu, you expect the noun that comes to take kasra. Kullu mithalin, each example, fil kismil awwal, in the first part, يتألف من. يتألف من is like يتركب من. يتألف من is composed of مبتدأ وخبر. It's composed of a subject and predicate. So if you look at the first part, this is what it's talking about. This part of what it's talking about. If you look at it, it's about مبتدأ خبر مبتدأ خبر. So it says كل مثال في القسم الأول يتألف من مبتدأ وخبر وهما أنيس مرفوعان. They are both مرفوع. Now as I've said, مبتدأ as we studied it is مرفوع. It ends in دوما. That is the subject ends in دوما. And the predicate which is the خبر also ends in دوما. So it says الولد جيد دوما دوما. كما علمت. So it says كما علمت as you've known. وإذا نظرت. And if you look إلى القسم الثاني to the second part which is where the كان and missus are added. رأيت الأمثلة عينها. You see the same example. عينها here means the same. You can use it and say جاء الرجل عينه. The man himself came. جاء الرئيس عينه. The president or the head himself came. You can use it like that. It is to show sometimes you see instead of عين you see نفس. So here you can see رأيت الأمثلة نفسها. That you can see it somewhere. So just put that عين or نفس to show that himself or herself. So if عينها herself or itself, عينه or نفسه, it can come like that. رأيت الأمثلة عينها. And the عين and نفس, they take the same vowel as this one. So رأيت الأمثلة عينها. Taking fatha. So you see the same examples. So when you look at the second partition, you see that the same مبتدأ and خبر are there. They are available. But بعد أن دخل على كل منها after okay, let's go like this. بعد أن دخل على كل منها أحد الأفعال. After one of these verbs, أحد الأفعال, one of the verbs, these are the verbs he's talking about, كان and ancestors. After they've entered and دخل على كل منها, after each of the sentences has gotten one of these verbs introduced into it. So the second partition is the same sentence, but كان has been introduced, صار has been introduced, ليس and so on. Okay. So let's see what it goes. وإذا تأملت أواخر الأسماء. If you should look very well at the endings of the nouns في هذا القسم, in this partition, that is the قسم side, the second part where كان and missus are added, if you look at the endings of the words, okay, says وجدت الاسم الأول. You find the first noun مرفوعا. As I said, the مبتدأ stays as it is. It still takes its ضمة. في كل الأمثلة, in all the examples, the first noun still takes its ضمة. والاسم الثاني, and the second noun منصوبا. So we have the first noun, which is the مبتدأ, keeping its مرفوع, and the second noun becoming منصوب. في جميعها, in all of it, in all the examples. وما حدث هذا التغيير. أي وما سبب هذا التغيير. What caused these changes or this change? No, what he is actually saying. وما حدث هذا التغيير إلا من دخول الأفعال المتقدمة. Okay. And these changes حدث بمعنى وقع أو حصل. That is, this change did not occur except from the entry, دخول الأفعال المتقدمة, the entry of these verbs. كان, باتا, زل, أصبح, and all these. They are those that cause the changes. Because in the first part, when they were not there, everything was doma doma. When they were introduced, now one of the domas which is that of the Khabar, has changed into Mansur, it has changed into Fatha. Okay. Says, فَهَذِهِ الْأَفْعَالُ إِذَنْ Then this verse, تَدْخُلُ عَلَى الْمُبْتَدَئِ وَالْخَبَرِ Then this verse, they are introduced to مُبْتَدَى and خَبَرِ You have a مُبْتَدَى and خَبَرِ, then this verse come. This is how they come in. فَتَرْفَعُ عَلَى الْأَوَّلَ So they make the first one, تَرْفَعُ, they make it مَرْفُوم. They make the first now مَرْفُوم. وَيُسَمَّى إِسْمَهَا So, this is what we need to note here. Before Kana came, the sentence we had Mubtada and Khabar. When Kana came, the Mubtada is no more called Mubtada. It is called Ismu Kana. This is what he means by Isma. Ism Kana. It becomes Is name. So we say Ismu Kana. Marfum. It is the name of Kana. It is the noun for Kana. Kana now owns it. So you say Ismu Kana instead of Mubtada. So if you see Wakana Allahu Ghafuran, Allahu here is Ismu Kana. But if you see Allahu Rahimun or Allahu Ghafurun, then Allahu is Mubtada. But when Kana and this says coming, then you say Ismu Kana. Or ismu adha or ismu bata, something it goes like that. Okay, so it says when they are introduced, tarfa'u al-awwala, they make the first one marfum, that is the mutada is still marfum, or yusamma ismaha, and it is called ismu kana, ismu bata, ismu asbaha, like that. Watansibu, and it makes the second noun, watansibu thani, and it makes the second noun mansub. That is what it means by tansibu. And watarfa'u means to make it marfum. Tansibu means to make it mansub. Wa yusamma khabaraha. And it is called khabar kana, khabar asbaha, khabar amsa, like that. So you say, the mubtada and khabar now become ismu kana and khabar kana. Like that. Okay. He says, وَيَعْمَلُ الْمُضَارِعُ وَالْأَمْرُ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَفْعَالِ عَمَلَهَا The مُضَارِع, that is the present tense of these verbs, كَانَ يَكُونُ بَاتَ يَبِيتُ, like that. The present tense and the command, كُن, like that. The command form of them, مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَفْعَالِ When you make the command form from all these verbs, or the imperative form, from all these verbs, they function just as the is as it is functioning now, as we have it. So if you see كان الله or if you see كان الله غفورا or كان الولد طويلا if you say يكون الولد طويلا they have to come, they have to function the same way. They have to come with the same function. Okay, so the mudari, the present tense form of the verbs, and the command imperative form, they all work just like what we've seen here. Okay, gaira anna, this is an expression, beautiful one. Except that, gaira anna, except that, laysa, the verb laysa, la yati minha mudari'un wala amr. From laysa, we do not get present tense. Nor do we get imperative form or command form. So laysa only conjugates to the past tense. It does not conjugate to the present. It does not conjugate to the imperative form or the command form. So you have laysa, laysat, lastu, lasta, lasti, laysu, laysa, laysata. It is only conjugated to the past. They were not, we were not, and all that. So he says, لا يأتي منها مضارع ولا أمر. You don't get مضارع or command form. You don't get present or command form from the verb ليس. Okay. Now we are coming to talk about the meanings. As I've already explained, so it will be a freestyle. He says, وَإِذَا تَدَبَّرْتَ مَعَانِي هَذِهِ الْأَفْعَالِ فِي أَمْثِلَتِهَا If you should ponder over the meanings of these verbs in their examples, Wajad tell Anna, you find that kena, the verb kena, to feed you it to solve in Mubtada bil khabar. Kena has this meaning. Anywhere you can take it like this. Kena to feed you it to solve in Mubtada bil khabar fi zaman al maadi. It to solve, I think we've already talked about this, it to solve in. Is it al-jumla al-mufida or this mubtada al-khabar, one of them? If you look at the mubtada al-khabar or al-jumla ismiya or maybe al-jumla al-mufida, we talked about itisaf al-mubtada al-khabar. That is describing the mubtada with the khabar. If you say al-waladu tawil, in a way you are saying the boy, you are saying the boy is tall, so you are describing the boy with length. Okay. So kana comes to say sorry. So when you have kana, what it does is that it takes this description to the past. It is solved in mutadai bil khabar fi zaman al madi, in a past time. So if you say al-waladu tawilun, the boy is tall. You are describing the boy with tall now. If you say al-waladu tawilun. But if you say kana al-waladu tawilun, al-kana al-waladu tawilun, kana al-waladu tawilun, the boy was tall. Fi zaman al-madi. Okay. And sara tadullu ala tahawuli al-mubtada'i min halin ila hal. Sara also means tadullu ala, refers to tahawul al-mubtada. Tahawul means changes or conversion. Tahawul al-mubtada, the transformation of the mubtada, min halin, from one condition, ila halin, to another. So if you say min halin ila halin, it means one condition to the other. And laysa tufidu an-nafi. Tufidu an-nafi. Laysa gives us the meaning of negation, which I said is not. It means it's not. An-nafi, negation. Amma aswa asbaha amsa adha wazalla bata fatufidu. These ones, this is their meaning. Tufidu itisaf al-mubtada bil khabar بالصباح والمساء والضحى والنهار والليل على الترتيب. Okay. I don't think we need this على الترتيب. We need this. This is the function. على الترتيب means respectively. So he just mentioned أصبح أمسى أضحى ظل بات together. And he gives us their function. They also cause, they also mean itisaf al-mubtada bil khabar, giving the mubtada the description of the khabar, giving it the khabar as a description. There is the same sentence, al-walad tawil, the boy is tall. This doesn't have time factor. It means the boy is tall. I'm just saying he's tall. But if I say asbah al-walad tawil, I am describing him as being tall, but in the morning. He says tawqeet, timing, the itisaf al-mubtada, description of the mubtada, bil khabar, with the predicate, bis sabah, ay fi sabah, in the morning. So asbah means in the morning, and then amsa means in the evening, or in the afternoon, in the evening. Or adha means in the morning, the time as I described. And zolla means to remain, but in the afternoon, an-nahar, daytime. And bata means to remain, but fi layl, at night. This is what he means here. Al-tartib means sequentially or respectively. Okay, I think we've taken a lot of time. Let's look at our qawaid shaft, and then we go. The qawaid is also lengthy. Okay, al-qawaid, the rulings. This you need to just capture them right away. It says, تَدْخُلُ كَانَ عَلَى الْمُبْتَدَئِ وَالْخَبَرِ Kenna joins Murtada and Khabar. When you have Murtada and Khabar, this is the kind of sentences that Kenna joins. Okay. When it joins, what does it do? Tarfa'u al-awwal. It makes the first one marfu'. When you summa, and it is called isma'a. That is ismu kana. Watansibu al-thani. It makes the second one mansub, and it is called khabara'a. That is khabar kana. Or khabar asbaha. Or khabar any of them. So you have ismu asbaha, khabar asbaha. Like that, any of them. And then we have mithlu kana fima taqaddama, just like kana in this explanation that is given to kana here. So it says mithlu kana fima taqaddama, like just like kana in this explanation is sara laysa asbaha amsa adha zalla bata. So they all do this function of tarfa'u al-awwal wa yusamma isma'a. They all do the same thing. So it says mithlu kana fima taqaddama. I just like kana in just what we read, what we just read, is these verbs. Wa tusamma hazihi al-af'alu, and these verbs are called akhawatu kana, the sisters of kana. Okay. And then we have likulli fi'lin min hazihi al-af'al, for each verb among these verbs, mudari'un wa amrun. They all have present tense verb. You can conjugate them to present, like asbaha yusbihu, like bata yabitu, zalla yazallu. You can have your present tense, and you can have your command form, which is the amr, imperative form. So you convert them, like asbah or something like that, to become or become. You convert them into command. They all do the same function. It says ya'malani amali ma'ad. They all function as the past tense, because the ones you just studied, all of them are past tense. It says the present tense and the command form, this and that, they do the work ya'malani amali ma'ad. They do the function of the ma'ad. Except that, illa, except, laysa, except the verb laysa. فَلَا يَأْتِي مِنْهَا مُضَارِعٌ وَلَا أَمْرٌ. ليس does not have مضارع, neither does it have أمر. Okay, I hope it has been clear. In case anything is unclear, replay it and refollow it. If it's still unclear, the comment section is for you. You can ask your question there, or you can send me an email. I will be sure to attend to it. I'm very active with my email. I will attend to it. Except that when, because the time differences between countries, you may send it and it will be the night time here, so it will be late. But in any case, I will do my best to respond to it. Okay, so if you have any queries, any questions, anything that is unclear, you call my attention to it. I will clarify it, inshallah. I will do my best. The aim is to make Arabic language easy for us to understand the concept of the language, inshallah. Okay, I pray you have a very good Arabic time. To meet again. Have a nice time. Stay safe. Bye-bye.